Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we'll be treating highest common factors, that's HCF. Like in our last class, you can watch our previous video on LCM. Today is HCF. We have different methods of solving HCF, but I'm going to use the simplest method for us so that we can always find our way around it in a very simple way. Unlike LCM, you have to solve, look for the numbers till you get to the last step, which is until you get 1-1. But this time around, let's see how we can work around it. So let's start with question number one and see the method we can always use to solving HCF. So let's say solution. Awesome. So for solution number one, very good. We have to find the HCF of 12 and 20. There are a lot of methods, like I said earlier on, but I'm going to use the simplest method for us. Since we have idea of how to solve LCM, we'll still use the idea here, but just take note of some things. Very key. This time around, it is HCF, not LCM. So for HCF, unlike LCM, you start with 1, you will still get the same number. So we advise not to use 1 because we will get the same number. Then we'll move to the next one, which is 2. The moment 2 can divide any of the number, you use it. The same thing goes to 3 like that. But in HCF, you look for the number that can go in both this and this. If it is 3, we have in the 3. Look for the number. It's only the number that can go in the 2 at the same time that you will use. The moment there is no number that can go in any of the 2 again, you stop. Unlike LCM, that is until when you get to 1 before you stop. So let's go. Like now, for 12 and 20, we've been advised not to use 1. For 12 and 20, 2 can go. So we start with 2. Awesome. So how many times will 2 go in 12? That's 6 times. And how many times will 2 go in 20? That's 10 times. Awesome. We move to the next stage. 2 can still go in both 6 and 10. So we'll still make use of our 2. Very good. Awesome. So how many times will 2 go in 6? That's 3 times. And how many times will 2 go in 10? That's 5 times. Very good. Looking at 3 and 5, can any number go in 2 of them at the same time? 3 and 5? The answer is no. If you use 1, 1 will still give you the same number. If you use 2, 2 cannot go in any of these. If you use 3, 3 can only go in this and not this. 4 cannot go in any. If you use 5, 5 can only go in this. So the moment you find yourself in this situation, in HCF, you stop. That is where you stop. So let's put our line as usual. Very good. Unlike LCM, until when you get to 1, but in HCF, the number you will use to divide must go in the 2 or the 3 or the 4, depends on the situation at hand. So for this, what we need to do now is our HCF will now be 2. Let's get our multiplication sign. Very good. Because we have 2 and 2, yes, just 2 of them. So that's what we are going to deal with. 2 times 2 will now give us what? 4. That's our answer. That's our HCF. The HCF of 12 and 20 is 4. Let's go to question number 2. We have 2 numbers here as well. So that's just the little difference between LCM and HCF. We have a lot of method, but I think this is one of the easiest and simplest method in solving HCF. As usual, we have two numbers here. Let's try and see how we can work around it using the same method. Awesome. Don't forget, like I said, you will use the number that can go in two of them simultaneously. So we have 16 and 24 here. As usual, let's start with 2. Awesome. So with this, how many times will 2 go in 16? It is very easy. 8 times. How many times will 2 go in 24? 12 times. Awesome. So 2 can still go in 2, in the 2 number. You use the number that can go in both at the same time, unlike LCM. So 2 can still go in these 2 numbers that we have here. 2 can go in 8, 2 can go in 12. So how many times will 2 go in 8? That's 4 times. How many times will 2 go in 12? That's 6 times. Very good. Look at this number, 4 and 6. 2 can still go in 2 of them, so we'll still make use of our 2. Very good. So with this, how many times will 2 go in 4? That's 2 times. How many times will 2 go in 6? That's 3 times. Looking at this number, 2 and 3, there is no number that can go in 2 of them simultaneously again, like when we started. So we'll stop here. So with that, let's draw our line. We have it here. Very good. We have it here. Awesome. We have it here. Very good. So with this, let's get this template that will make use of here. So this time around, we can now say our answer, our ACF will be 2 times 2 times 2. That's going to be our answer. That's 8. So 8 is the HCF of 16 and 24. Let's move to the next one, question number 3. Two numbers, 25 and 50. We are looking for HCF. Very good. So with this, let's do away with this. Awesome. Unlike LCM, we are looking for HCF this time around. HCF, now HCF of 25 and 50. 25 and 50. Like we said, you look for the number that will go in 2 of them simultaneously, not 1. So looking at this, we've been asked not to start with 1 unless there is no number that can go in the 2 at the same time. So our ACF will be 1. But for this, 2 can go in 50, but not in 25. It will remain. So 3 cannot go in both of them. 4 cannot go in both of them. So 5 can go in both of them. So we start with 5. We start with what? 5. So how many times will 5 go in 25? That's 5 times. How many times will 5 go in 50? That's 10 times. Awesome. Look at these two numbers. What number can go in 2 of them simultaneously again? It's 5. The number that can go in 2 of them at the same time, we are solving HCF, not like LCM. So you look for the number that can go in them at the same time. 5 goes in 5, it will give us 1. 5 goes in 10, it will give us what? 2. Awesome. So there is no number that can go in 1 and 2 at the same time any longer. So let's put our line This is one of the methods used in solving HCF. There are other methods too, but a little bit cumbersome and more technical than this one that we have here. So you can make use of this one. It is very easy and straightforward. So let's make use of this method. Awesome. So let's get this line here. Get another one. There we go. So with this, you can now see, let's get this template. Very good. So with this, you can now see our ACF will be 5 times 5. Awesome. 5 times 5 will give us 25. So 25 is the ACF of 25 and 50. So let's move to the next one, question number 4. This time around, 3 of them, 9, 18, and 24. 9, 18, and 24. For question number 4. Awesome. So let's do away with this. So don't forget, in HCF, you look for the number that can go in all at the same time. Unlike LCM, that once it can go in just one, you are good to go. But for HCF, you look for the number that can go in all at the same time. Look at this, 9, 18, and 24. 2 can go in 24 and 18, but not in 9. So you move to the next number, 3. So 3 can go in 9, can go in 18, can go in what? 24. So let's make use of 3. Awesome. So how many times will 3 go in 9? That's 3 times. 3 times. How many times will 3 go in 18? That's 6 times. And how many times will 3 go in 24? That's 8 times. Awesome. So we have 3, 6, and 8. So which number will go in 3 of them at the same time? 3 can go in 3 and 6, but not in 8. 4 can go in 8, but not in 6 and 3. It will remain. 5 cannot go in any. 6 can go in only 6. So as a stand, because we are solving HCF, there is no number that can go in 8, 6, and 3 perfectly at the same time. So we stop here because we are solving HCF. So let's draw our line. As usual, put our line here. Awesome. Very good. So we are home and dry. So the ACF of 9, 18, and 24 is what? Is 3. Because we only have 3 here. So that is our answer. So let's move straight to number 5, which is the last one. You have to look for the ACF of 18, 21, and 27. 18, 21, and 27. Awesome. So with this, you can see. Very good. So we can do away with this. Don't forget, in ACF, you will look for the number using this method anyway that can go in 3 of them at the same time. At the same time, if there is no number that can go in 3 of them at the same time, your answer is 1. So, as usual, let's go. Let's start with 2. 2 can go in 18, but not in 21 and 27. So we are not going to make use of 2. So we move to the next number, which is 3. 3 can go in 18, can go in 21 and 27. So we'll make use of 3. Awesome. So how many times will 3 go in 18? That's 6 times. How many times will 3 go in 21? That is 7 times. How many times will 3 go in 27? That's what? 9 times. Awesome. So we'll move to the next one. Let's check 3. 3 can go in 6, but not in 7, but can go in 9. 4 cannot go in any of them. 5 cannot go in any of them. 6 can go in only 6, but not in any of these. 7 can only go in 7, but not in any of these. 8 cannot go in all. 9 can only go in this. So with this, that means no number can go in 3 of them simultaneously at the same time. Let's put our line. So with this, that means our answer, the ACF for 18, 21, and 27 will be what? 3. That's the highest common factor. The highest common factor in 3 of them is 3. So our final answer will be what? Be 3. Very good. So that's our final answer. You can always pause, rewind this video for better clarification and understanding. Don't forget to subscribe to this YouTube channel, My Simple Maths, and you can always press the notification bell to get notification of our new video. Thank you.